What's up, Navigation Traders? Welcome to this week's video update. Today's Friday, November 8th. Hope everybody had a great week of trading. We are reporting live from Las Vegas, Nevada. Our one and only Dr. Chad Searcy brought the heat, talking about the Iron Duck at the Traders Expo here. And so we're heading out tomorrow. So it's been a good week. Met some good people, good traders. So if you ever get the chance, make sure you come out to a trading event like this. It's a great place to interact with other traders. Let's jump in, starting with who got caught being hot. And this week goes to Thomas Girard. Hope I'm saying that right, Thomas. But Thomas is a newer trader, and he continues to ask a lot of great questions, just getting feedback, posting a lot, and you know, just the fact of asking all those questions not only helps him learn, but I know is helping some other newer traders as well. So Thomas, keep up the heat. You got caught being hot. Let's jump into the alerts, starting with Monday the 4th. And our first trade was an opening trade that we did in SPX. And we did an Iron Duck. Now, with implied volatility so low, that's when we really need to go further out to get the kind of the risk reward that we're looking for on these ducks. So we went out to 21 days to expiration, gave us a max profit of 610, which is also where we will exit if we get to that point on the downside, on the loss point. And then at that point, we were still holding our other Iron Duck in SPX with 9 days, which we later took off this week in a alert I'll get to here in a minute. But let's go to the platform and take a look at SPX. At this one. So here's where we're at. Price has moved even higher since we put this on. So you can see we're nearing the beak profit there. Still got a lot of time left. If we move our break even over to just at the base of the duck beak, you can see there's still over 33% chance that price can get back down here into that max profit area. So we're not looking to take that off yet. If this gets down to under 10% chance of getting back into the max profit, we will just take it off and move on. But for now, we're going to be holding. Next trade was a rolling adjusting trade in /NG, which is our nat gas. So we've got two pieces in nat gas still. We've got the two different sets of short strangles. Got down to 21 days to expiration, so we rolled one of those out to January, and then we're still holding the other one in the previous cycle. Now we're down to 17 days to expiration, which, you know, technically as far as kind of timing, we could have or, you know, potentially should have rolled the other one as well, but I'm just giving it over the weekend to see if we can squeeze a little bit more juice out of it before we roll that second piece. So if we go to Natty Gas, here's the one that we just rolled. And you can see price has come down since we did that, so we've made back a little bit of profit since we did that roll. Still got a decent buffer to the downside. Natty Gas has been, I mean, just look at this thing, huge swings, and which has actually been good. It's kind of got us back into center of these two positions. And then here's the other one in the previous cycle. You can see we're over 50% of max profit. And again, I'm just holding this over the weekend. We will roll this Monday to the next expiration cycle and just continue to work our way back to profits in Natty Gas. Next trade, rolling adjusting trade in Apple. So this is a long put vertical we've continued to hold for that short delta exposure. Unfortunately, Apple has been extremely strong. So we went ahead and rolled this out to adjust our strikes, get us back to that positive theta position. Had a question about this in the community this week, so let me address that. Let's go to Apple. So we rolled this to, you know, kind of bring price back into range, because when price is in range, and you can see when I move this price slice, look at the theta right there. If it's inside of our range, you're seeing a positive theta number, meaning as those top options decay, as we get closer to expiration, that's working in our favor. But watch when I move the price slice out of range, you'll see that theta number start to go negative. So, you know, as soon as it gets out of range, we're not gonna make any adjustments. You don't want to over adjust. But price had run quite a bit higher, and so we were getting down in November to the last week of expiration anyway. And so we went ahead and rolled this out to get that price back into range, get that theta number back to being positive, working in our favor, and just to continue to keep that short delta exposure in our portfolio. So that's where we're at on Apple. In regards to the rest of our portfolio, we've got about 2.5 to 1 on our short delta to our theta. So we like to keep it in that range of kind of 1 to 1 to 5 to 1, in that range somewhere, just keeping some short delta in, you know, for the case where we do see some downside velocity. Obviously, when the market is just continuing to rip higher like it has, you know, that short delta hurts. I mean, you know, we have not had a downtick in October, it doesn't feel like. So obviously that short delta is going to work against you. But, you know, it's kind of we talked about this in the community, it's kind of a double-edged sword. You know, when the market's going up, you wish you didn't have any, but when the market goes down, you wish you had more. So that's why we always just keep some short delta in our portfolio. You know, it's going to work against us on the way up, but it's going to benefit us on the way down. And especially if we have a big move down, that's when it really comes into play. So that is the game plan. Next trade, a opening adjusting trade in ZB. So we had a short strangle in ZB, and then price kind of moved out of its range a little bit. So we added another short strangle just to collect some more credit, kind of widen out our overall break evens on the trade. So if we go to ZB, bonds have been really weak. And so here's the one that we have that we already had on, and you can see price has moved out of the range here. Got some questions about, you know, are we going to adjust this one? Well, what we do is we look at how much value is left in that untested side. So if we look at just the calls, you can see we still have a decent amount of premium left in those options. So we're not looking to roll those calls down yet. If price continues much lower, then that's what we'll do. We'll roll those calls down lower. But for now, we're just holding. Now, here's the one we just added, just another centered strangle. You can see price has moved a little off center and we're down a little bit because implied volatility has gone up on that one, but still obviously well within range, close to center. So just holding that piece at this point. Next trade, opening trade in RUT. So we put on a weekly double calendar. We did this with 9 days to expiration just because that was the available options in RUT. Doesn't have as many expiration cycles as like SPX. So we went ahead and did a couple days later, 9 days to expiration on the front week, 24 days on the back week. And so we are still in that. Let's take a look at RUT on the platform. And I did this in RUT because we've already got an iron duck in SPX. So I didn't want to muddy the waters in the same symbol too much. So that's one of the reasons we chose RUT here. So you can see we've got a little bit of profit here in this weekly double calendar, but just holding on for more. We're going to hold this all the way up close to expiration unless we have to bail early. So we've got 6 days to expiration. So late next week will be when we look to potentially take that off. Next trade, opening trade in IYR. So implied volatility had a big spike earlier this week in IYR. So we went ahead and sold some premium, defined our risk using a kind of a tight iron condor with IYR being, you know, under $100 symbol. We looked at doing a short strangle, but the buying power just didn't really make a lot of sense. And you can't do a wide iron condor because the price is too low. So we'd like to do kind of a tight iron condor in cases like this. So if we take a look at what that looks like on the risk profile, you can see we're up about $100 on the trade, but just waiting for some more profit before we do anything there. And when we tighten these in like this, we like to book profits a little bit earlier. So it's almost kind of like in between a butterfly and an iron condor, where, you know, butterflies were managing like 20 or 25% of max profit. And iron condors were looking at 30 or 40. Well, this is kind of in between. So kind of 25 to 30% of max profit is where we're looking to take that one off. Next trade, closing trade in CL oil. Booked another nice profit in oil. Oil continues to be a great trading vehicle, very profitable for us. So we are out of oil at that point. Next trade, rolling adjusting trade in QQQ. So one of our sets of short call verticals we rolled from November to December and adjusted the strikes appropriately, kind of similar to what we just talked about in Apple. Keeping that short delta exposure, getting us back to a positive theta position. And so we still have one in November, which we'll address this and potentially roll that next week. And then here's the one that we did roll. So prices moved up a little bit, but we're still within range from where we rolled that one. Next trade, we did a opening earnings iron duck in Roku. And so this just had 2 days to expiration when we put it on. Roku made a pretty decent move down after earnings. Let's take a look at the chart. ROKU made a big move down after earnings and kind of held. And then today, Friday, it bounced a little bit higher. got right in our duck head and we shot that duck right in the head. So that's a nice trade in Roku. Next trade, opening adjusting trade in ZW in wheat. So we added an iron condor in wheat and then we took off our previous one. So we booked over 50% of max profit on that piece of the trade and then reopened one in the next cycle. I mean, technically you can kind of think of this as rolling, even though it's two different trades, it's two different alerts. Essentially, we're just closing one out and reopening it in the next cycle with new strikes, just still working our way back to profits in wheat. So if we take a look at our iron condor and wheat, still fairly centered, just waiting for some more time to pass on that one. Next trade, closing trade in /6B. So had a nice little down movement in 6B. Had to make a couple adjustments to this trade, but just staying mechanical. Ended up booking a profit of 250 after adjustments. So we're out of 6B. And let's take a look at FXB, the corresponding ETF. I was looking to potentially get back into this. Yeah, implied volatility is popping back up. So next week, assuming implied volatility doesn't crash, we're gonna get back into 6B, sell some more premium. You can't trade FXB. The options just aren't great in there. They're a little bit wide, 20 cents wide. It's just 6B is a much better trading vehicle. So look for an entry into 6B early next week. Next trade, closing trade in SPX. So that was our other iron duck that we had on in SPX. This one still had 6 days to expiration, but with price being so strong, it just ran up that beak. And so we just went ahead and took that off, booked that beak profit, and redeployed that, or have that capital to redeploy. Still a 6 day. So we're not going to hold the trade for 6 more days when the chance of us just getting that big profit are very high, over 90% chance of taking that big profit. So we just want to take that and run and use that capital elsewhere. Next trade, opening trade in booking BKNG, another earnings iron duck. And this one with just 1 day to expiration. So we put this on Thursday and then we closed it out today on Friday. And what we did on Friday today was we just let it expire. And so if we go to booking, you can see what happened after earnings is, that doesn't look right. Oh yeah, okay, so yeah, it was down. Oh, that was before earnings, that's right, okay. So that big down day was actually in reference to Expedia announcing earnings. Booking had a big drop before they even announced. They announced, looked like maybe a little bit of an overreaction, so it actually opened up the next day. So when we put on our iron duck, we ended up right here, way up in the beak. So we ended up just letting these options expire, booked a profit of $202 per contract on that one, which we just did one contract in the alert. So nice, another nice duck trade there. Next trade, rolling adjusting trade in DIA. So one set of our short call verticals in DIA, we rolled from November to December, kind of a similar situation to QQQ, just adjusted those strikes, extend duration, keep that short delta in our portfolio and get that back to a positive theta. So if we look at DIA, we've got two pieces on here. This is the one we just rolled. You can see prices right here, right where we rolled it today. The other piece here with three contracts, prices just right around the break even, just outside the break even. So again, just holding that for that short delta exposure. Next trade is the closing trade in Roku. So I already went over that. And then lastly, the closing trade in booking. So book those two iron duck profits. So those are all the alerts. Let's take a look at some of the other positions, starting with ES, another short delta position, long put vertical. That one's basically at max loss at this point. So you can't get assigned on futures until after they expire. So there's no hurry here. So we're just gonna hold this one pretty close all the way up to expiration. If by chance in the next week we get a big move down in the S&Ps, that'll benefit us, but we can't really get hurt if it continues higher at this point from where it is. So we're just gonna hold on to that into late next week. GC, I mentioned gold, I mentioned Natty, I mentioned bonds, I mentioned wheat, I mentioned Apple, booking John Deere. We've got another short delta position here. Price is just outside the break even. Just looking for some more downside to benefit that. IWM, same thing, another short delta position. Long put vertical here, just looking for some downside to benefit that. IWR, I mentioned QQQ, RUT, SMH. We've got this adjusted short strangle. You can see price has moved out of our range. But similar to what I was talking about before, if we look at just the untested side, you can see there's still some decent premium left in those puts. So we are not looking to roll those puts up quite yet. I'd love to add to this one, but I mean, IV percentile is at one. IV ranks at one. There's no premium in these things. So not looking to add to that, but we'll just continue to manage our current piece. SPY, we've got an iron condor. Price is hanging out up here in the upper end of the range. So just looking for some downside to get back into center and some more theta to decay in our favor on that one. And then XLK, another short delta position. This is also a long put vertical. Just looking for some downside to get back into range there, just outside the break even. And then XRT, we've got what we put on as a short strangle. Originally, we adjusted it into a straddle. See, since we adjusted it, we're up about $127. We're down a tiny bit still overall in the trade, but in good shape, well within range. So just holding on to that until we get out. You can see kind of a big spike and then a contraction in that implied volatility. So we're in good shape there, just looking to hold that and look to take that off once we get into profits. So like I said, next week, look for 6B, look for us to get back into oil. Let's take a look at USO. Where's the implied volatility on that today? Yeah, it's really starting to just steadily decline. So if we get a little bit of a pop in implied volatility, we may look to get it back into oil next week, but definitely 6B, and then continue to manage these. We'll look for some more earnings, iron ducks, and other potential iron ducks in ETFs or indices as well. Everybody have a great weekend. Talk to you next week. See ya.